हेलो एवरीवन, माय नेम इज़ अब्दुल करीम, वर्किंग एज असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर लॉर्ड्स इंस्टीट्यूशन ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग एंड टेक्नोलॉजी हैदराबाद। वी आर स्टार्टिंग ए टॉपिक दैट इज़ यूटिलाइजेशन ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिकल एनर्जी। सो इन दिस यूटिलाइजेशन ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिकल एनर्जी वी आर गोइंग थ्रू द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिकल हीटिंग। सो बिफोर गोइंग टू द सेशन, लेट अस नो वॉट इज यूटिलाइजेशन ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिकल एनर्जी। यूटिलाइजेशन ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिकल एनर्जी मीन्स यूटिलाइजेशन इज द एंड प्रोसेस, विच मीन्स when we are generating electrical energy, after that we are distributing that to the household purpose, for the industrials, everywhere. So how we are utilizing that electrical energy, in what manner we are utilizing that utilization of electrical energy and the electrical heating. What is electrical heating? If a current is flowing through a conductor, that particular conductor having a high resistivity, so that opposes that current flow. So when you oppose the current flow, then what happen? Heat will be produced. When current is passing through the conductor, it gets heated up due to I square R losses. So this heating will be used for the domestic purpose and industrial purpose. If you see the diagram here, one battery is there, from positive it is flowing through a resistance R. So the voltage is the difference between the point A and point B, and the current is flowing through this R, which means this resistance. So the heat will be depend upon this particular resistance, right? This is the concept of electrical heating. So there are some domestic appliances are there in our day-to-day life. We usually see these domestic appliances like iron box, electric kettle, electric cooker, oven and immersion water heater. So these are the domestic appliances which we are using for the purpose of heating. So by this heating we are using to water heater, food cooking, etc., etc. So coming to the industrial appliances, what are the industrial appliances? In industry we want to somewhere we want to melt the metals, and we have to form any different the structures and the shapes, and we somewhat we want to heat up the water. In hydropower plants we want to heat the water by the help of water furnaces and water boilers. There also we are using electrical heating only. So in the industrial purpose, industry electrical heating furnaces are there, and industry electrical boilers are there. Depending upon the application point of view, we are using the electrical heating appliances in the industry. So coming to the advantages of electrical heating over the other heating system. What are the other heating systems means, like a gas heating system, coal heating system, oil heating systems. Coming to the gas, which means there are LPG gas, CNG gas like that, and oil means diesel, petrol, kerosene like that. So there are some points: economical, cleanliness, absence of fuel gases, easy of control, efficiency, automatic protection, better working conditions, safety, upper limit temperature, special heating requirements. Here electrical heating is economically advantage than other heating system like gas, coal and oil. How? Which means coal is very rare, it is non-renewable resources, so we have to mine that coal from the underground, and we have to transport, we have to crush, we have to filter that coal. So the entire process will take is very cost. Okay, so coming to electrical heating, just we have to arrange a electrical furnace. Okay, so in economical point of view it is better than other heating system. So cleanliness, so electrical heating system is very cleanliness. Why? Because there is no pollution, there is no fuel gas, there is no wastage. Absence of fuel gases. This absence of fuel gases means if you burn coal or any oil systems, it will gives you harmful gases. So electrical heating is better than other heating systems in the point of view of absence of fuel gases and easy of control. Fourth point, we can easily control electrical heating, and efficiency. So efficiency is 80%, electrical heating efficiency is 80% compared to other heating systems. And better working conditions, automatic production, we can arrange automatic production devices in the electrical heating systems. And safety, there is no radiation in the electrical heating system. and special heating requirements, whatever element we want to heat, electrical heating is far better than other heating systems. Coming to next slide, that is a heating element. So here we are talking electrical heating concept. Now looking for the what is the particular element to heat. If you are producing electrical heating, if you are boiling the water with from what material you are getting heat, so that is element is called nothing but a heating element. A heating element converts electrical energy into heat through the process of resistivity, otherwise known as Joule heating. The electric current passing through the element encounters resistance which produce heat, right? Typically heating elements are made of coil like a ribbon and strip and wire type shaped. So property of element, heating element, property of heating element, here we have some properties. It should have high specific resistance so that a small length of wire can produce sufficient amount of heat. If you see the diagram here, we are having a wire which is having a cross section area A and length L, and rho equal to resistivity, so R equal to rho L by A. This is the electrical heating formula, which means nothing but resistivity formula. So rho is the resistivity, L is the length, A is the area of cross section. So properties of heating elements should have high melting point so that high temperature can be obtained. It should have low temperature coefficient since for accurate temperature control. And it should not oxidize at high temperature, otherwise the life is shortened. Coming to the next slide, commonly used heating elements. What are the commonly used heating element in domestic and industrial purpose? There are some elements, some metals are there which are used for electrical heating elements: nickel, chromium, iron, nickel, chromium, aluminium, nickel, copper. The use of iron reduces the cost but lowers the life of that element. Methods of electrical heating, classification of electrical heating. So in this electrical heating we have two different types, that is power heating and another is high frequency heating. So in power frequency heating we have three types. One is resistance heating, arc heating and electron bombardment heating. In resistance heating, again it is classified into three types: direct resistance heating, indirect resistance heating and radiant heating. In arc heating there are two types, that is indirect arc heating and direct arc heating. Coming to high frequency heating, there are two types: induction heating, dielectric heating. So in induction heating we are looking, again they are classified into direct induction heating, indirect induction heating. So in power frequency heating we are seeing that resistance heating. The heat produced by passing through an electric current through a material that preferably high resistance, which means here it is having a charge, this is the charge, this one we want to heat up. So for this what we are doing, we are putting two electrodes giving power supply to the electrodes. Here high resistive power is there, powered is there. Here high resistive power is there. By this high resistive element heat will be produced. Why? Because the flow of current is continuously going through this charge, then this charge will heat up. Coming to indirect resistance heating, what happened? The same mechanism, but we are placing a chamber here. In this chamber we are placing two resistance, these are the resistive heating elements, and the heating chamber, this is called heating chamber, and the charge is there, this one we want to heat up, this is the charge. Okay, so the same mechanism we apply, but indirectly we are heating this charge. Here directly electrodes are striking to the charge, directly they are striking to the charge. Here we are indirectly striking to this charge. Okay, this is the difference between indirect and direct. Coming to the next one, arc heating, that is indirect heating and direct heating. The indirect arc heating is nothing but indirectly we are heating this charge by the help of electrodes. The same mechanism we have to apply here. The power supply has to be given to this electrode. Indirectly arc will be produced between the two electrodes that showers into the charge where we want to heat up. Thanks for watching.